Ito pong ebanghelyo na ating binasa ay isa pong halimbawa ng estilo o pamamaraan ng pagtuturo ng mga rabbi o mga eskriba o mga naatasang magturo tungkol sa salita ng Diyos. Gumagamit sila ng mga salawikain o kasabihan o sa English ay proverbs. Dito sa ating ebanghelyo, gumamit din ang ating Panginoong Kristo ng mga salawikain o proverbs. Kaya lang, he applied a hyperbolic style. Sa English, hyperbole. Ibig sabihin, yung pagmamalabis na larawan o paraan ng paglalarawan. But it should not be taken literally. It is an exaggerated form to drive home a message to stress a very important point. Why did Jesus use exaggerated proverbs? Because from the point of view of Jesus, God's ways are different from our ways. The ways of God's kingdom are not necessarily in step with our human ways. That's why on one occasion he said, new wine should be poured into new wineskins. In other words, Jesus was trying to open the eyes of his listeners to view things from an entirely new angle. That's why listeners commented, we have never heard anyone speak like this before. Ang tinutukoy ng ating Panginoong Kristo sa kanyang pangangaral na paggamit ng mga salawikain ay upang ipahiwatig na ang pagiging alagad ni Kristo, ang pagiging alagad niya ay hindi biro. Foxes have holes and birds have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Exaggerated. Anong punto ng ating Panginoong Kristo? Ang kanyang kababaang loob. The lowliness of the Son of God who humbled himself. Ibig sabihin, ang sino mang susunod o tagapagsunod, tagasunod ng ating Panginoong Kristo, he has followed the way of humility. That's why in the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians chapter 2, verses 6 to 11, he says, though he was in the form of God, he did not deem equality with God something to be grasped at. Rather, he emptied himself and took the form of a slave, being born in the likeness of men. He humbled himself, obediently accepting even death, death on a cross. Because of this, God highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name above every other name. So, Jesus is telling us that if we want to follow him, we should follow the path of humility. And if we are humble, then, only then, can we expect blessings from the Lord. The first will be last, and the last will be first. Ang sumusunod kay Kristo ay hindi dapat itinitaas ang kanyang sariling bangko. We follow the path of humility. Let the dead bury their dead. Paano ba namang ilibing ang patay ng kanilang katawan? Patay na eh. What Jesus was telling this young man was this: the spiritually dead should bury the physically dead. In other words, sinasabi ng Panginoon Jesucristo, huwag mo nang intindihin kung anong nangyayari sa bahay niyo. Sapagkat marami namang naiiwan doon. Ibig sabihin, not everybody is as passionate to follow Jesus. There could be someone who is passionate enough, who is enthusiastic enough to follow Jesus, but there are those who are complacent. There are those who are unadventurous. They are left behind. So, sabi ni Jesus, they will be the ones to bury your father. No one puts a hand to the plow and looks back is fit for the kingdom of God. Sapagkat yung pamamaraan ng pagbubungkal ng lupa noong kapanahonan ng ating Panginoong Kristo ay gumagamit sila ng araro, the plowman, no? The plowman has to hold with one hand the plow, and then with the other hand he drives the cow or the oxen, the hard-headed oxen. So he has no time to look back, because if he looks back, then the furrow will not be straight. In other words, Jesus was telling his followers, would-be followers, when you follow me, do not focus so much on what you have left behind. Do not focus on your loss. Do not focus on your pain. Do not focus on your unworthiness. Or you feel sorry for what you have given up. You keep on doubting. You're entertaining your fears. You focus so much on what you have lost, on what you have given up, rather than focusing on what Jesus, the Lord, can give you. Kagaya ng ating santo na ating pinagdiriwang ngayong gabi, ngayong araw, si San Lorenzo Ruiz, ibinuwis niya, isinugal niya ang kanyang buhay. Itinaya niya ang kanyang buhay. Kaya sabi niya, if I have 1,000 lives, I would gladly give them all to God. Jesus is asking us to be with Him, to follow Him, to be adventurous, to be passionate about the kingdom of God. That's why on one occasion He said, put your net into the deep. Do not remain in the shallow waters where it is safe. No? Cast your net with me. Cast your life with me. Marunong kang sumugal. Itaya mo ang iyong buhay para sa akin. I will not let you down. I will take care of you. Cast your net into the deep. Ibig sabihin, ang sumusunod kay Kristo ay dapat sumunod siya sa mga utos ng Panginoong Jesucristo. Napakahirap. Hindi biro. Bagong pag-iisip. Bagong gawa. Bagong hamon. Love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who mistreat you. Give to the one who asks. And if anyone has taken something from you, do not demand it back. Do to others as you would have others do to you. Do not judge. Do not condemn. Forgive and you will be forgiven. Give and it will be given back to you in full measure. At sa kahuli-hulihan, sabi ng Panginoong Kristo, hindi naman lamang paghihirap, hindi naman lamang pagsasakripisyo. Then, if you do all these things, what I command you, then your reward will be great. We need to cast our net into the deep with Jesus. Jesus demands faithful commitment. Huwag tayong masasayangan kapag tayo'y gumawa ng kabutihan. Huwag tayong matakot sapagkat Jesus is telling us, be courageous, be adventurous, cast your life with me, and I will take care of you. I always like that episode in the Old Testament when Moses and the Israelites were about to occupy the promised land, Canaan. He sent 12 men as a reconnaissance team, as spies, to look into the promised land. What was there? He sent 12 men, and among these 12 men were Joshua and Caleb. After 40 days of reconnaissance, they came back, and the 10 men reported this. Yes, it is true that Canaan is flowing with milk and honey, but their cities are fortified and so large. And not only that, the inhabitants are giants, and we are like grasshoppers. We are no match for them. With a flick of their fingers, they can defeat us, the Jebusites, the Hittites, the Amalekites. Only two had the courage to say, we should go up and take possession of the land, for we can certainly do it. The two were Joshua and Caleb. And they continued, if the Lord is pleased with us, he will lead us into the land and will give it to us. The Lord is with us. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Yes, you may be undergoing physical difficulties, incurable illness. You may be undergoing a difficult relationship. You may be praying for someone who is incorrigible. You have many problems and difficulties, like Joshua and Caleb. The Lord is telling us, do not be afraid. We are to stand for God even when others will not, even when it is so difficult. When we do, God will bless us in so many ways that will extend beyond our wildest imagination.